Perimeter, Area, and Volume, A Monster Book of Dimensions by David A. Adler and illustrated by Edward Miller. Have you ever been to a 3D movie? 3D movies look real. If there's a monster walking on the screen, it may seem as if he's walking toward you. As the monster on the screen gets bigger and bigger, it seems as if he's coming closer and closer. Such movies are called 3D. Because they seem to have three dimensions. They seem to have length, width, and depth. The three dimensions are sometimes called by different names. You might say something is tall, high, or long, wide or broad, deep or thick. Whatever words we use, all things we can hold or walk around have three dimensions. Here are the monster stars of the movie Monsters in the Neighborhood. They're posing for a picture. Are they all the same size? Some might be the same height, but not the same size. Height is just one dimension. Each monster has three dimensions. Each monster is tall or short. Each monster is wide or narrow. Each monster is fat or thin. To really know how big something really is, you need to know all three dimensions. But sometimes, you need to know just one dimension. In the movie, Monsters in the Neighborhood, the monsters are bothered by noisy neighbors who run across their yards and look in their windows. The monsters decide to put up fences. Before they can buy the fences, they need to know how long each side must be. They need to know the total length of the fence around each yard. Length is just one dimension. Take a look at these two yards. One is bigger than the other. How much fencing would the monsters need for each yard? To find out, add up the lengths of all the sides. When you add up the sides of each yard, you're finding its perimeter, the distance around. The distance around a circle is its circumference. To find the circumference of a circle, you first measure its radius, the length of the line drawn from any point on the edge of the circle to its center. Then you double its radius and multiply that by pi, which is about 3.14. Look at the posters outside of the movie theater. Each has a drawing of a monster. Do the monsters in the posters look real? It's difficult to make a drawing look completely real because real things have three dimensions and a picture has two dimensions. Pictures have just length and width. Pictures and the surfaces of flat objects have two dimensions. How big is the movie screen? If the side of each square is 1 foot long by 1 foot wide, the area of the square is 1 square foot. Count the squares. You are finding the area of the screen. Look again at the screen. It's a rectangle. It has 4 straight sides. Its opposite sides are the same size, and all 4 angles are right angles. To find the area of a rectangle,
multiply
its length by its width. The length of the screen is 12 feet. The width of the screen is 16. Its area is 12 times 16. Its area is 192 square feet. Area measures surface. It's a two-dimensional measure. Get a ruler or tape measure. Measure the area of this page. It's 10 inches long and 8 inches wide. To find the area of this page, multiply the length by the width. Square inches, square feet, square miles, square centimeters, square meters, and square kilometers each measure area. This book has three dimensions. The very top of this page to the bottom is the book's length. the left side of this page to its right side is the book's width. When you close this book and look at the pile of pages all bound together, you're looking at the book's third dimension, its depth or thickness. At the movies, you can buy a large box of popcorn or a jumbo box. Which box is bigger? That's easy. The jumbo box is bigger. What makes one box bigger than the other? One box is bigger than the other because it's higher, wider, or thicker. When any one of the three dimensions increases, the size of the box increases. Of course, when both boxes are filled, the jumbo popcorn box has more popcorn in it than the large box. We call the amount a box holds, or the space anything with three dimensions takes up, its volume. The larger the box, the greater its volume. The jumbo box is 8 inches high, 6 inches wide, and 4 inches deep. To find its volume, multiply 8 by 6 by 4. The volume of the jumbo box is 192 cubic inches. The larger box is 6 inches high, 4 inches wide, and 3 inches deep. To find the volume, multiply 6 by 4 by 3. The volume of the large box is 72 cubic inches. You can compare the volume of many boxes by measuring the three dimensions of each and then multiplying. A cube has three dimensions, height, width, and depth. So we measure volume in cubic measures. A cubic inch is a cube that is 1 inch high, 1 inch wide, and 1 inch deep. A cubic centimeter is a cube that is 1 centimeter high, 1 centimeter wide, and 1 centimeter deep. Cubic inches, cubic feet, cubic centimeters, and cubic meters each measure volume. Tonight's the opening night of Monsters in the Neighborhood. The monster stars and their families have come to the premiere. It's time for pictures. The photographer tells the monsters and their families to line up. He wants short monsters in the front and tall monsters in the back. In lining up the monsters, the photographer is only interested in one dimension. He's only interested in the height of the monsters. It starts to rain. The photographer puts away his camera. The monsters rush to get inside, but the door is not made for monsters. Some of them are too tall to get through. Some are too wide to get through. The door frame has two dimensions. It has height and width. Now it's time to go home, but it's still raining. There are lots of raincoats in lots of sizes. The biggest monster will need the biggest raincoat. The size of each monster is determined by how tall or short, how wide or narrow, and how fat or thin the monster is. Perimeter and circumference are the distances around one-dimensional shapes. Area is the space inside a two-dimensional object. Volume is the space a three-dimensional object contains. Monsters and everything you can hold, pick up, or walk around have three dimensions. The end.
Hello, I hope you enjoyed today's math story. So the next part is for teachers and parents. And I'm gonna go over with you are some math standards and the grade levels that touch on these standards so you know when to use this story. Also, if you click on the below link, you'll see some resources that I found online that are free, and that way you can continue on with the learning. So let's go over the standards. The K represents the kindergarten. MD is gonna be our domain
and the domain in this case will be measurement and data. The A will be the standard, and then the 1 will be the clusters, so you have a lot more underneath it. So for the first one in kindergarten is to describe measurement attributes of objects such as length or weight, and then describe several measurement attributes of a single object. For the second standard is directly compare two objects with a measurement attribute in common to see which object has more of or less of the attributes and describe the difference. So those are going to be your kindergarten standard right there. For grade 1, still going to be under the domain of measurement and data. And then in this standard says order 3 objects by length and compare the lengths of the 2 objects indirectly by using a third object. So you're using a third object and you're comparing it. Is it shorter than or larger than? Similar to what we did in kindergarten right here, comparing that right there. The second standard is to express the length of an object as a whole number by length units by laying multiple copies of a shorter object end to end. So you can start comparing how much of it it is shorter or longer than something. In grade 2, we still have measurement and data right there as our domain. And in our standards, it says to measure the length of an object by selecting and using appropriate tools such as rulers, yardsticks, meter sticks, and measuring tapes. So as you can see in kindergarten and in first grade, they're not using necessarily a tool to measure, but it's a comparison of something, objects that they're comparing it to. So in grade 2, though, now they're using the measurement tools and now starting to find the units for that. In our second standard, students are now comparing the length of the object twice using length units of different lengths for 2 measurements. Describe how the 2 measurements relate to the size of the units chosen. So it's similar to the previous ones. They're doing measurements, but then also talking about the units of it. So it's like now 3 inches longer or 2 inches shorter. Now they're using the units to compare that. And then on this next standard is then using inches, feet, centimeters, and meters. And then in the fourth standard, determine how much longer one object is than another, expressing the length difference in terms of standard unit length. In grade 3, the measurement and data standard, the students are now using liquid and doing volume and masses of objects using standard units in grams, kilograms, and liters. And they're using one-step word problems in order to find the volumes and masses as well. In the next standard, they're generating measurement data by measuring lengths using rulers marked with halves and fourths of an inch. Then in our next standard, recognizing area as an attribute of plane figures and understanding concepts of area measurement. The next one is going to be measuring areas by counting unit squares. So that's the little squares that they were talking about in the screen size, the movie screen size, so similar to that. And then in this standard, relating area to the operations of multiplication and addition. So then they're actually finding the area. So they can use the little squares to count it up, or they can do the length times the width. Now in grade 4, we're applying the area and perimeter formulas for rectangles in real world and mathematics problems. Then in grade 5, they're converting the different size standard measurement units within a given measurement system and use these conversions in solving multi-step real world problems. They're also going to take the volume as an attribute of solid figures and understand the concepts of the volume measurements. In this standard, students are measuring volumes by counting unit cubes using cubic centimeters, cubic inches, cubic feet, and improved units. And then in this standard, students are relating volume to the operations of multiplication and addition and solving and mathematical problems involving volume. In the sixth grade, now our domain changes, and now it's a domain of G, which is geometry. In this standard, students will find the area of right triangles, other triangles, special quadrilaterals, polygons, and composing rectangles or decomposing into triangles and other shapes. And also the next standard is having students find the volume of a right rectangular prism with fractional edge lengths by packing it with unit cubes of the appropriate unit fraction edge lengths and show that the volume is the same as would be found by multiplying the edge. So now they're doing the volume using the formula for the volume, but also they're having units of fractions involved as well. And then in this standard for sixth grade, students will represent three-dimensional figures using nets. Nets are going to be objects that you cut around and you tape them together. And from there, they will then figure out is the volume for that. Then in grade 7, the standard is having students describe two-dimensional figures that result from slicing three-dimensional figures, as in plane sections of rectangular prisms and right rectangular pyramids. The standard also has students doing real-world mathematical problems involving area, volume, surface area of two and three-dimensional objects composed of triangles, quadrilaterals, polygons, cubes, and right prisms. And in eighth grade, under the still domain of geometry, students will know the formulas for the volumes of cones, cylinders, and spheres, and use them to solve real-world problems. Then in high school, the domain for this is still going to be under geometry, but it's called geometry, measurement, and dimensions instead. The standard will have students use volumes formula for cylinders, pyramids, cones, and spheres, similar to eighth grade. In the standard, students will identify shapes of two-dimensional cross-sections of three-dimensional objects, and identifying three-dimensional objects generated by rotations of two-dimensional objects. So this is more of a calculus standard right here. Students will do a lot of rotations and then also finding the area when they slice the object. In this last standard for high school, the domain has changed to geometry and it's modeling with geometry. And the standard is applying concepts of density based on area and volume in modeling situations. Again, this probably wouldn't be affected until calculus, these last two standards right there.
Goodbye. We'll see you at the next math story.